I'm Dr. Sri, I'm a board certified family medicine, sports medicine doctor, and I practice in the United States, Kentucky. So when you think about diabetes, we always think about type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Type 1 diabetes is caused due to insulin deficiency or complete lack of insulin, whereas type 2 diabetes is due to insulin resistance. There is another variant of diabetes called as the maturity onset diabetes of young, which is due to a genetic mutation and is frequently misdiagnosed. So in this video, we're going to talk about maturity onset diabetes of young, how is it diagnosed, and how is it treated. Without further ado, let's get started. So before we go further, let's understand some basics about diabetes. Our blood sugar tries to stay in the normal range between 70 to 140 milligram per deciliter at all times. There might be a slight number of spikes after we eat meal, but still, most of the time, our blood sugars should stay within this range. So after eating, or sometimes even during stress, our blood sugar levels spike. So the pancreas detect these blood sugar rises and they release insulin to normalize the blood sugar levels, thereby making sure that it's always between 70 to 140 milligram per deciliter. So basically, when a patient is presenting with type 1 diabetes, basically what that means is that the antibodies is attacking the cells that secrete insulin from the pancreas, and thereby they have insulin deficiency, and that's what we call as type 1 diabetes. But let us say the insulin is not able to act on the muscle and liver properly. There is resistance to the action of insulin in the muscle and liver. That's what we call as type 2 diabetes. So now that we have covered type 1 and type 2, what is maturity onset diabetes of young? So remember we talked about where when your blood sugar goes up, your pancreas has to sense the high blood sugar and thereby release the insulin and thereby bring the blood sugar back to normal range. But let us say if there is a problem with the sensor, so that the pancreas is not able to sense the high blood sugar spike, that's what we call as maturity onset diabetes of young. And there are almost 14 variants, of which 1 to 3 is the most common form of MODY that we see all the time. The MODY is an autosomal dominant genetic condition. What that means is that, let's say if I have maturity onset diabetes of young, there is a 50% chance my offspring will also have maturity onset diabetes of young. Even though the pancreas still has enough stores of insulin, since there is a problem with the sensor, it is not secreting properly, and thereby they still have a relative insulin deficiency. So when I say relative insulin deficiency, it means that for a particular blood sugar spike, there is relative insulin deficiency. But let's say when the blood sugar goes up, then the insulin starts to secrete properly. When we think about complications that arise from diabetes. So let us say my sensor is saying that, okay, so after 250 milligram per deciliter, that's when I'll start to secrete insulin, which means that the person is going to have chronic hyperglycemia, basically chronic high blood sugar, and thereby they're still going to have complications. So it's important that even though there is normal levels of insulin stores in the pancreas, still the relative insulin deficiency is a problem, and we have to treat to help bring the blood sugar back to normal range. So patients with maturity onset diabetes of young, they're present in early age. So they're going to be diagnosed before the age of 25. They're usually non-obese. So remember, it is not due to insulin resistance issue, it is an insulin deficiency issue. So they're usually non-obese, and they mimic exactly like type 1, except that with maturity onset diabetes of young, you're going to see high blood sugar ranges, not really high like we see in type 1 diabetes, like, you know, 400s, 500s, but usually we might see at around 200s, 300s or so. But the problem is that they still can mimic type 1. So during the initial phase of type 1 diabetes, people may not have really high blood sugars. So they can be kind of similar to maturity onset diabetes of young. So that presents a lot of challenge. For example, one challenge is to make sure that this person does not have type 1 diabetes. So we do antibody testing to make sure that the person does not have antibodies to the pancreas, thereby able to rule out type 1 diabetes. The other thing that we use is called as the C-peptide test. So basically, this comes after breakdown of insulin. So let us say if someone has insulin deficiency, then we're not going to see C-peptide levels in the blood. So that helps us to diagnose that this person might have type 1 diabetes. But the key here is that, let us say if I have MODY and if I'm fasting, now if I check my C-peptide levels might be low because of the relative insulin deficiency that we talked about. So usually, sometimes what we, when we check the C-peptide levels, we tell patients to eat a good amount, a good breakfast or a good lunch, so that the blood sugar spikes really high, and then we check the C-peptide levels to see if the insulin is still being produced or not. So genetic testing can confirm the diagnosis of MODY. However, the expense is often a barrier. So let us assume that the patient walks in my clinic and they have a high blood sugar, they are non-obese, and they are at a young age. So now I want to find out whether this person has MODY or whether this person has type 1 diabetes or type 2 diabetes. The fact that this person is not obese, I'll be thinking about mature onset diabetes of young and a honeymoon phase of type 1 diabetes. But usually the easiest way to solve or to diagnose MODY is to make sure that we do the antibody testing, the C-peptide testing that we talked about, and do the genetic mutation testing. However, when I see some patients, they don't have enough money to cover all these tests. In that scenario, what I'll do is that the first step that I'll do is to make sure that if their A1C is more than 9, and if the answer is yes, then I would try to talk to see if they can get on insulin. Because if the A1C is really high, it's important to make sure that we bring the blood sugar back to normal range quickly. And then once the A1C becomes less than 7, then we talk about a trial of oral agent. Again, when we do that, I'm kind of making sure that they check the blood sugar regularly and we're just keeping a close eye on them. But again, if there is any suspicion that this person have type 1 diabetes, then they're going to be on insulin forever. But let us say if the person's A1C is less than 9, so it's slightly elevated, and then there's no a huge concern for type 1 diabetes at this point, then usually we start with a trial of sulfonylurea. So what the sulfonylurea does is that, let us assume that a person has maturity onset diabetes of young. We talked about it is a sensor issue. So let us say if I eat, and if my blood sugar goes up to 300, and then my pancreas starts producing insulin, basically if I tell my pancreas to produce insulin while I eat, then my blood sugars can stay in the normal range. So what the sulfonylurea does is that it basically goes and tells the pancreas to produce more insulin, and thereby help to address the blood sugar spike that comes after a meal. Unfortunately, even though sulfonylurea works really well, and there are studies that shows that people can be on sulfonylurea for many years with lifestyle modifications and just the medications alone without the need for insulin. But still, there are some patients who might eventually need insulin because of the chronic stress that could be causing hyperglycemia, or the sulfonylurea may not be working properly among certain patients because of insulin deficiency also. But again, this is where you work closely with the doctor to make sure what treatment regimen might work well for you. But the biggest difference between type 1 and maturity onset diabetes of young, which one has to know, is that maturity onset diabetes of young can mimic like type 1, but they respond really well with a medication that increases insulin because there is no insulin deficiency. However, in type 1, this medication is not going to work because there is no insulin at all produced by the beta cells of pancreas. So that's why it's important to make sure that you have the right diagnosis so that you're not in the wrong treatment. But otherwise, the whole goal of managing diabetes, irrespective of whether it's type 1, type 2, or maturity onset diabetes of young, is to make sure that we keep the blood sugar under normal range at all times. Make sure that we address the lifestyle. Make sure that the person is eating healthy, exercising regularly, so that they don't develop insulin resistance. One thing that we have to understand is that type 2 diabetes is due to insulin resistance, and anybody can become a type 2. So a normal person without diabetes can become a type 2. A person with type 1 or maturity onset diabetes of young, if they have unhealthy lifestyle like poor eating habits, not exercising regularly, they can also have insulin resistance, and thereby they develop type 2 diabetes. So it's important to make sure that we address lifestyle modification at all times, including treatment as above. In some patients, if they are having a lot of insulin resistance along with maturity onset diabetes of young or type 1 diabetes, in that case, we use some medications that can improve insulin resistance, and we treat basically both as type 1 and type 2. So let us say, for example, that this person has maturity onset diabetes of young but also have insulin resistance. In that case, we might have to give sulfonylurea to produce insulin. We might have to give another medication to improve insulin resistance or to help with weight loss, such as the newer injections that that curbs both appetite and also helps to increase insulin. So if you want to know more about how exercise can help with diabetes, then check out this video here. If you want to know more about diabetes medications that are available in the market, then check out this video here. And I'll see you in the next video. Until then, goodbye.